don't feel nothing but the most high power.
I'm going to ask a question. Can anyone give me the definition of slander? Does anybody know what slander means? Anyone?
Falsely accusing.
Falsely accusing? Right? Anybody else? Okay. So as Brother Ben said, it's falsely accusing somebody, okay? Or you have the definition which says a malicious, false, defamatory statement or report against somebody. All right, so you're saying something about somebody that did not occur or that person did not do, okay? That's slandering somebody. All right, the Bible talks about that clearly. There's lots of scriptures that you can go into the Bible concerning slander. All right, but I want brothers and sisters to get the understanding of what slander is according to the Bible. Okay, and what Most High thinks of it. All right, and why we shouldn't even be dealing with it. Period. None of us. Not to nobody. Keep it to yourself. If it comes into your mind, keep it to yourself. Tell yourself. Because when you start spreading it from one person to another, this is where that slander begins. Okay? Because now you're telling somebody what you think, okay, what you think in your mind is supposed to be true. I can talk about somebody else while it's not. And now that person is telling this person, and they're telling this person, and people are like, man, I don't even know what to believe. Okay? But we're going to go into the scriptures and we're going to see exactly what the scriptures talks about slander and what the Most High has to say about slander and how he looks at it. Alright? Let's go to Proverbs 16 and 6. Or Proverbs 6 and 16, Salaki. Proverbs chapter 6, verse 16. And you can read to the 19th verse. Read it.
Proverbs chapter 6, verse 16. These six things does the Most High hate. Ye seven are an abomination unto him: a proud look, a lying tongue, hands that shed innocent blood, and heart that devises wicked imaginations, feet that be swift in running to mischief, a false witness that speaketh lies. And he that soweth discord among brethren.
Read that again. Read 19 again.
A false witness that speaketh lies, and he that soweth discord among brethren.
So the Most High is telling you there's six things that does he hate, and the seven is abomination. Okay? And it tells you the six things, and it tells you the seventh. Okay? Alright, a false witness that speaketh lies, and so discord among brethren. Because when you're speaking lies, okay, telling these things to one another, okay, this is the discord that you're sowing amongst the brethren. Okay? This is what the Most High doesn't want. The Most High ain't even dealing with this. Alright? Go to Proverbs 10 and 18 for me, y'all.
Proverbs 10, verse 18. He that hideth hatred with lying lips, and he that uttereth slander is a fool.
Is a what?
Is a fool.
Is a fool. Okay, I'm not saying this. The Most High saying this. This is coming from in the Word. You're reading it for yourselves. Okay? So you're hiding, you hide it, and you have hatred with lying lips. Okay, you're uttering slander. You are a fool. If you're dealing in that, as the scripture says, you are a fool. Okay? No. Go to Proverbs 12 and 18 for me.
Proverbs 12 and 18. There is that speaketh like the piercing of a sword, but the tongue of the wise is health.
Okay. There is that speaketh like the piercings of a sword, but the tongue of the wise is wealth, is health. Okay. So there's some people, okay, that, listen, they don't even have to touch you, but it's like you get stabbed with a knife just by the words that they say to you. Okay? Or the words that they say about you. It's better they even just slap you in the face or something. That would have been way more easier or tolerable to deal with than people speaking certain things. Okay? It's like getting a stab wound. Okay? Go to Proverbs 25 and 23 for me.
Proverbs 25, verse 23. The north wind driveth away rain, so does an angry countenance, a backbiting tongue.
Read that again.
The north wind driveth away rain, so does an angry countenance, a backbiting tongue.
Okay, the north wind driveth away rain, so does an angry countenance, a backbiting tongue. Okay? Alright? Leviticus 19 and 16. Okay, let's see what the Most High says concerning a slanderer, a backbiting tongue, somebody who's bearing false witness. Okay, because if that's what you're leading it to, bear false witness, that's a commandment that you're breaking. Because now you're telling somebody something that's not true. You're claiming to be the witness of what you're telling them. You are the witness. You saw this with your own eyes. You heard it with your own ears. You're the witness. You're bearing false witness to someone. Okay? Leviticus 19 and 16.
Leviticus 19, verse 16. Thou shalt not go up and down as a talebearer among thy people.
Read that again.
Thou shalt not go up and down as a talebearer among thy people.
Read.
Neither shalt thou stand against the blood of thy neighbor. I am the Most High.
Okay, so the Most High said, don't walk up and down as a talebearer among thy people. Alright? Do not go from place to place telling tales that you have no knowledge of. Okay? Don't be doing that amongst your own people. Don't do that. Alright? Psalms 101, verse 5.
Psalms 101, verse 5. Whoso privily slandereth his neighbor, him will I cut off.
Read that again.
Whoso privily slandereth his neighbor, him will I cut off.
Read.
And him hath an high look and a proud heart will not I suffer.
Okay, so the Most High say, whoso privately slandereth his neighbor, the Most High is going to cut him off. Okay? Him that has a high look and a proud heart will I not suffer. When you see that word suffer, the Most High say, he's not going to suffer you to keep on going on. But he's going to cut you off. He's not going to help you, no way. Alright? This is the Bible talking about a slanderer. Alright? So anybody who wants to be in this business of slander, just be aware exactly of what the Most High is saying concerning if you would choose to go about living this lifestyle. Okay? Matthew 15 and 18 and verse 19.
Matthew 15, verse 18. But those things which proceed out of the mouth come forth from the heart, and they defile the man.
Okay, so the things that come forth out of the heart, okay, or come forth out of the mouth, come forth from the heart. Okay? And there's another scripture where Christ says, from the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. Okay? So these are the things that are inside of you. Okay? That sometimes can be unrighteous, not right.
witness.
What?
False witness.
Really?
Blasphemies. These are the things which defile a man.
Okay. For out of the heart proceed evil thoughts, murders, adulteries, fornications, thefts, false witness, blasphemies. Okay? These are the things that defile a man. So these are all these evil things that you have inside of you that nobody can see, but eventually when they do come out, okay, people know exactly what you're dealing with. They know what kind of spirit you're operating in. Okay, they know if you're righteous or if you're unrighteous by these things that proceed out of you and come out of your mouth. Alright? Ephesians chapter 4, verse 29.
Ephesians chapter 4, verse 29. Let no corrupt communication proceed out of your mouth.
Read that again.
Let no corrupt communication proceed out of your mouth.
Read it.
But that which is good to the use of edifying.
To the use of what?
Edifying.
To the use of edifying. Read.
That it may minister grace unto the hearers.
That it may minister grace unto the hearers. Okay? So let no corrupt communication come out of your mouth. Let no slander come out of your mouth. Let no tale-bearing come out of your mouth. Backbiting come out of your mouth. Okay? But that which is good to the use of edifying a brother or a sister. Okay? That's what should be coming out of your mouth. Alright? 1 Timothy 5 and 13.
Timothy 5 and 13. And withal they learn to be idle, wandering about from house to house, and not only idle, but tattlers, also the busybodies, speaking things which they ought not.
Read that again.
And withal they learn to be idle, wandering about from house to house, and not only idle, but tattlers, also and busybodies, speaking things which they ought not.
Okay. It says, and withal they learn to be idle. Some people, they have nothing doing, they don't work. Okay, they wander around from house to house. Okay, busybodies. Alright? Speaking to this person, speaking to that person, talking things that they shouldn't even be talking. Saying things against other about other people that they shouldn't even be saying. Because why? They don't have no facts. But this is the spirit that some people are operating. You know, and they come before you all nice and loving and, you know, innocent. Like, they don't do nothing. Not know that in their own secret time or their private time, this is what they're doing. Actually, 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 1 to 5.
2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 1. This know also that in the last days, perilous times shall come, for men shall be lovers of their own selves, covetous, boasters, proud, blasphemers, disobedient to parents, unthankful, unholy, without natural affection, truce breakers, false accusers, in contempt, fierce, despisers of those that are good.
Read that again. Read verse 2 again.
For men shall be lovers of their own selves, covetous, boasters, proud, blasphemers, disobedient to parents, unthankful, unholy, without natural affection, truce breakers, false accusers, in contempt, fierce, despisers of those that are good.
Okay, despisers of those that are good. So you're going to have some man walking around that are going to be dealing with these spirits that this brother just read out, or where the Bible is speaking, all right? And you're going to be despisers of people that are good, that are not dealing in this kind of spirit. Because they're going to look at this brother and say, well, or this sister and say, well, she thinks she's too good. She thinks she's too early. Oh, he thinks he's too good. He thinks he's too holy. So what is he supposed to be, wicked? Are we supposed to be holy and perfect as our Father in heaven is perfect? That was a commandment. Maybe you should try doing the same. Maybe you wouldn't be worried about looking at another brother or sister, how they're operating in the spirit. But if you're operating in the spirit, you'd be too busy worrying about how to keep your righteousness in the spirit. the kingdom of heaven or not. Okay? How are you going to do that? By obeying to these laws, statutes, and commandments. Okay? If you don't obey to these laws, statutes, and commandments, listen, you ain't going into the kingdom. All right? Continue reading for me, brother. Verse 3. Read verse 3 again.
Without natural affection, truth breakers, false accusers, in contempt, fierce, despisers of those that are good, traitors, heady, high-minded, lovers of pleasures more than lovers of the Most High.
Read that again. Read verse 4 again.
Traitors, heady, high-minded, lovers of pleasures more than the lovers of the Most High.
So some are going to be traitors, heady, high-minded, lovers of pleasures more than lovers of God. Okay? And trust me, we got some brothers and sisters that are operating in this kind of spirit as we speak. All right? Read on.
Having a form of godliness.
Having a form of godliness. Coming up to you now, pretending, yes, I love Jesus. Yes, I love the Most High. Brother, how are you doing today? Everything good? Then go behind your back and yeah, okay? This is the form of godliness that they portray before they'll come to you, you know, missing the halo, you know, and the angel's wings, but yeah, you're all righteous, never done wrong in your life. Okay? Read on.
From such turn away.
Read 4-5 again for me.
Having a form of godliness, but denying the power thereof.
But denying the power thereof. Okay? Denying the righteousness. Okay? Read.
From such turn away.
From such turn away. Have nothing to do with them. When you see exactly what they're about, have nothing to do with them. Colossians 3:8.
Colossians 3:8. But now ye also put off all these anger, wrath, malice, blasphemy, filthy communication out of your mouth. Lie not one to another, seeing that ye have put off the old man with his deeds.
Read that again.
But now ye also put off all these, anger, wrath, malice, blasphemy, filthy communication out of your mouth.
Filthy communication out of your mouth. Read.
Lie not one to another, seeing that ye have put off the old man with his deeds.
And lie not one, don't tell each other lies, seeing that this is the old man that you've put off when you've been baptized. This is the old man that you dropped in the water. You're not supposed to be operating in the spirit no more. Newness of life. When you rise up out of that water, you rise up. Listen, it's like a new slate. Because now you're lining up with scripture. So now you can, that's right there is an example to a brother or sister. You don't even know how much good you're doing by just walking righteous. Okay? All right, but on the other hand, not only you're not operating in a certain kind of spirit, but an unrighteous spirit now, and another brother or sister is here and receiving you now, then what do you want them to think now? They're going to probably look at you, especially if it's a sister who's young and true, or a brother who's young and true. They're going to probably think that, well, if this brother can do it, then I guess it must be okay. If this sister is doing this, I guess it must be okay. Not knowing that you're there to be an example for this brother or sister, and not to operate in a certain spirit, or not to walk in a certain way, or not to talk certain things. All right? 1 Peter 3 and 10.
For he that will love life and see good days, let him refrain his tongue from evil and his lips that they speak no guile.
So read that again.
For he that will love and see good days, let him refrain his tongue from evil and his lips that they speak no guile.
For he that will love life, okay, so if you love life, all right, you love your life and you want to see good days. Refrain your tongue from speaking evil. The scripture is saying it so clear. Alright? It's telling you, if you love life, right, you want to see good days, meaning you want to live long and see good days while you're living long. Okay? Refrain your tongue from speaking evil and your lips from speaking guile. Okay? Unrighteousness. Uncleanness. Alright? The scripture is putting it out there clear as day. Okay? A little child can understand these things. Alright? It's not hard to comprehend. Okay, it's a shame that I don't understand why, you know, some of our brothers and sisters that can't understand this. You understand? Matthew 12 and 36. We're gonna read to 37.
Matthew chapter 12, verse 36. But I say unto you, that every idle word that man shall speak, they shall give account thereof in the day of judgment.
Read that again.
But I say unto you, that every idle word that men shall speak, they shall give account thereof in the day of judgment.
Most I say, every idle word that you speak, okay? Every man and every woman shall give an account at the day of judgment. Every idle word. That's why it says, yo, if you have nothing good to say, don't say nothing at all. That's a worldly saying. Keep your mouth shut. Because every idle word, you are going to be judged. Every idle word. Idle or even not idle, you're going to be judged. Whether the words be good or bad, you're going to be judged according to your righteousness and according to your unrighteousness. All right? Read.
For by thy words thou shalt be justified, and by thy words thou shalt be condemned.
Read that again.
For by thy words shalt thou be justified, and by thy words shalt thou be condemned.
Okay, so it's clear. It says, for by thy words thou shalt be justified. So if you're speaking